What's really, really good, my people? This your boy, Smallito. This is Smallito's Way. Coming at you with another video. Hit that like, hit that share, hit that subscribe button. Much love to all my supporters. Let's get into this. So, apparently last night, Richard Sherman, who's a famous cornerback. He's been in the NFL for quite some time. He played for a long time for the Seattle Seahawks, Legion of Boom, won a championship, a Super Bowl. His last team was the 49ers. Well, anyway, long story short, he was arrested last night, and apparently they're charging him with all type of shit. Burglary in his own house. I don't know how that happened. Domestic. And they're saying that he fought with police, too. So, right now, he's currently being held without bail, which is amazing to me. I mean, he didn't murder nobody. He didn't hurt the cops, as far as I know. He didn't hurt nobody, you know, mortally injure anybody or something like that. And to not give him bail is pretty, pretty, pretty surprising. He has a hearing tomorrow where I'm sure he will get bail. But even if, like, he should have been afforded bail off the rip. So that's what it is. They released some of the 911 calls where his wife called in, and we know apparently she was trying to get the police over there to, you know, help him, calm him down. He was drunk. She said that he drank a whole bottle of vodka and a whole bottle of Henny. So, whew, he was finished. But if you hear these police tapes of, you know, her calling, the 911 operator was a complete bitch. Like, she was not trying to help. She was being very combative. She was being very argumentative. She was just really, really, instead of helping her and instead of, like, calming her down, which is what they're supposed to do, reassure you that things are going to be okay, that they're dispatching police or whatever the case may be, an ambulance, whatever you need, they're supposed to be supportive over the phone. Unless you're being belligerent or some shit, which she wasn't. She was trying to the best of her ability to explain the situation, explain what, you know, he had no weapons, you know, that he was being aggressive, and, you know, he didn't physically hit anybody, but she was upset, she was scared. You could hear it on her voice. But even though she was upset, she was still being helpful as far as describing what was going on at the scene. And this lady was really, really just a bitch. I don't know what happened. Maybe she woke up on the wrong side of the bed. It was the time of the month. I'm not sure. But she was really, really, I feel like she needs to either be fired or retrained, because if that's how she handles her job, then she's not good at her job. Of course, they overcharged him, I feel, because how the fuck are you going to charge him for burglary in his own house? Tomorrow, they're going to arraign him, so those charges could be changed, or it could be more charges or whatever. But, I mean, listen, this is what happens with the police, man. Anything happens, they're gonna charge you with it. If you step on a cop's foot, he's gonna charge you with assault. He's gonna say you hurt his foot, he got it, you know, whatever. This is how they do it, and that's not right. But anyway, I say this. This is just a quick little, you know, spill and tell y'all, you know, pretty much tell y'all what's going on, report on what's going on with Richard Sherman. And that's it. I'm going to keep y'all updated on whatever happens. I mean, it's, if it's important or whatever. But this is your boy, Smallito. This is another one for the books. Y'all be good out there, man. And always remember, hit that like, hit that share, hit that subscribe button, man. Show some love. I'll see y'all next time. Peace.